Namaskar. Good morning. Hope you are safe. Hope you are at home. Hope you are very fine, healthy, wonderful. And hope the same for your family also. And hope that you are productive. We are at home, but we are on job, meaning a lot for the future. And if you remember, I insisted upon to watch this second part of interview tips. This is more practical, more important, more full of non-verbal aspects, and this is going to help you a lot in your interview and panel and board-facing day. So let us begin. Are you ready? Let's start. We talked about for the interview. Now, at the interview or on the day or during the interview, how to behave, how to act upon, and how to be vibrant, and how to prove the best in front of the board. That is the thing. So, on the date of interview, you have to be on your toes, very much ready for this show. Well-groomed up personality and well-set to go for the verbal presentation in an extempore manner before the board to impress them, to convince them as far as your personality is concerned to be befitting for the post that you have applied for. Your communication skills matter a lot. After entering, wishing the board, taking the place or the chair, how you communicate. If you ask for a seat, and if they offer it, do you say thank you and then take the chair? How confident you appear. How a wonderful smile that you give at them. How you present yourself to be in an active listening mode, appearing to be submissive, appearing to be obedient, appearing to be functional. That is very important. You need to carry a lot of enthusiasm. You're passionate about it. And listen carefully. Take the question properly. Understand what they want. That's the saying, wahi bol jo log sunna pasand karenge. Speak that. That will be the best that a person will love to listen. To a single question, there can be multiple answers. But what is the best? So that the board will see a positive sense in that, the board will appreciate your gesture and will be happy to listen. For example, many a times they say, why you aspire for this job? I have heard several candidates talking, I am to serve the nation, I am to serve the society. Okay, that's it. I don't deny to that. But that's a very common answer. Everybody speaks so. So how to create an impression? What will be the best way to answer it? Best words to use, to be used, so that the person asking for it gets satisfied. You have to look into it. Be very careful in framing your sentences, using those words. When an engineering graduate appears to be into another segment, for example, into an insurance industry, into a banking industry, into a defense industry, or to be into a security segment like that, what you are aspiring for? You are already a graduate, you are an engineer, and again, why do you aspire for this? Why do you appear for this? How you think that you are the best? So it's not to put down your engineering discipline, or it's not to speak out that I am not finding a way out, but how best you can amalgamate your backdrop as an engineer to the upcoming job responsibilities, proving that you are the best one. You can work it out in the best possible positive manner, contributing the maximum output. So that can be clicking. Be honest. Don't bluff. Don't just speak in a half-hazard manner. Don't get caught. Your words and your actions should match. It's not to lie or bluff. Be honest about whatever you speak. Sell yourself. I mean, speak about whatever is the best in you. Project yourself out. Prove yourself with your virtues, your qualities, your credentials, your experience, so that the board feels you are the person they are looking for. Maintain a balance. It's not to be aggressive, it's not to be going very low. It's not to be giving a look at a single person, avoiding others. It's not to be louder, it's not to be very low in your voice. You have to maintain a balance. Be sober, be sound, and appear confident. Show the leadership qualities in you so that you are decisive. Show up that given a chance, you are ready to take over the responsibilities with all accountability. And of course, when you are in front of the board, table manners matter a lot. You have to be very specific when your table manners is concerned. Yes. Table manners. What I mean, you are carrying your credentials, your mark sheet, your portfolio, or your folder, or leather folder, or a executive suitcase, briefcase. You should not place it on the table. Neither you put your hands on the table, or you lean forward to occupy space there. Give your breathing space. Position yourself properly in front of the table. Be stable. Be composed. And be ready to take the questions. Be attentive. It is not to use it, the table in front, the table on which the panel is not for you. You are given a chair. That's what it is. So you occupy your chair, meant for you, with a thanks, note of thanks to the board or the panel, and be very stable. You may be getting 5 minutes, you may be getting questions for 25 minutes, 30 minutes, if you perform well. So in the meanwhile, you should not feel awkward or disturbed or very much hesitating or lifting your sides or bending this way, that way. You have to be very, very much steady and stable on the chair. So pull yourself back, rest your back on the chair very firm. But don't be rigid. Be flexible. All across wear a smile. And look at the panel, not a single person. Maybe a single person asking a question, take the question from the man, but when you answer, look at the entire panel. If you avoid, if you miss the rest of the panel, they will be planning a question next for you. So you use them all, you keep the entire board engaged. Wearing a smile, answer the question so that each one of them gets impressed. And be careful. When I say smile, it's not to smile always. For example, if you are given a question, farmer suicide in the state, what are your comments? So getting this question, is it expected that you will smile? No. You have to be serious. You need to appear concerned and answer. At times, things may be controversial. Get the permission from the chair and say that it is my ownership, but it is my opinion if I say so. If you feel like sipping a glass of water, ask for that. Don't just use it. You can take pause. After all of us are humans. Nothing to be nervous, panicked. So be very stable, steady, and composed. And use the chair properly. When you move the chair, take the seat, keep it in the proper position. Be firm in it till you say goodbye. And when you say goodbye, put the chair back where it was. That is the minimum manners. So we should learn these manners minimum as an etiquette when we face the board. So this is what it is. Project yourself in front of the board. Speak about yourself. Speak about the best part in yourself. Speak about the unique selling points, what you are. Speak about all your credibilities, all your positive aspects, all that what you are good at, all your winning edges, so that you will impress. Guess what makes you feel proud? And of course, you should feel proud about yourself. So many a times you'll get an open-ended question. Come on, introduce yourself. So what do you mean by that? We'll just go on by saying your name, your father's name, your mother's name, your total this postal address, starting from your school, college. No, it's not that. You don't find time for that. That will be boring for them. If you get an open-ended question like this, introduce yourself, speak something apart from that, what you have provided to them as in a sit, as your credentials or your CV or your resume, what they are carrying. You have already given them. They have the seat with them. You start by saying your name, but talk about all those virtues, all those attributes of yours that will love to listen. So you should know what are your strengths. You should very well establish your portfolio, customizing it to the job that you are aspiring for. So enlist things that you like to say about yourself. Think about what differentiates you from the rest. How unique are you? What are those unique qualities in you? Speak about it. Ensure to include evidence of your abilities. Maybe they doubt. Maybe they feel that you are speaking very high, you are boasting. So you should not forget to carry the collaterals to that. If they ask for a proof, you should be having it to show it. If you say that you are a good sportsman, if you say that you are physically fit, so if asked, you can show your six packs. So show your, be ready to prove yourself with evidence that you are talking about. Pick relevant aspects of your experience. You may be having number of experience about life, about situations, about several happenings. But speak about those that will relate to the specific job that you are applying for. That is it. And be very careful about your hobbies, interests, and extracurricular activities. People miss their. A lot of you take it very lightly. It's not that. Your hobbies, your interests, very much speak about your personality. Apart from your professional things, what are the things you do in your leisure hours? What are your extracurricular activities? So if I say your interest and hobbies, it means what will you love to do given a chance apart from your professional course or career or your studies, to be very specific. And these are certain things that goes along with the person. However stressed a person is, however busy a person is, he will love to do finding a chance, a scope, a time, because he loves that. For example, if you play a guitar and you're passionate about it, that's your hobby. Even at the dead hours of the night, if you get a chance, you will put your hands into it for 15 minutes at least, relieving your stress. And you need to see what you are into as far as extracurricular activities, hobbies are concerned. And being asked upon by the board, be honest to speak that. And if needed, prove it. If you say that I read, what do you read? If you say I read newspapers, you are tempting them to ask, speak about the headlines today. So get ready for 3, 4, 5 probing questions into it. If you say that I love to play football, you should know the national level football players, you should know the state football players, you should know the International Football Association, football matches, events. You should know that. So be specific. If you have time, choose it. Ask Dopan what you are going to put forth about your extracurricular activities, your hobbies and interest. And accordingly get ready so that on the spot, whatever they ask, you have to say and show it. That is very important. That is what you need to behave like when you are in front of the board. Project yourself and project yourself well. Say about all the good things that is inside you. Say all your virtues and qualities, why exactly you shoot for the job, why you demand the job, why they should select you. Speak about the best things in you in relevance to the post or job. If it is a police, combined police services, you can say about your physical activities, sports, games, athletic events, swimming, running, climbing, horse riding. Because there are certain activities that will be of much help in the professional career. So look into it and well set for the board. That is what you are going to talk on that. And when you present, your presentation should be effective. When you speak, when you get an open-ended question to comment or to opine upon, you have to show a passion and speak that what they will love to listen. That is what I say, connect with the audience. Look into the eyes and panning across all the board members, you answer your questions, the questions. So connect with the audience well. Focus on the audience needs. Guess what they want you to say. Never speak anything anti-organization or anti-government. You should be very careful being tempted upon to give an opinion. How about Article 360? How about the CAA or CAB? So you have your opinions in place, but be very careful in placing your things without any controversy, without putting down anyone. And be very careful when you quote someone. If you quote someone, you need to take the name of the person or personality, and you have to be very careful in taking the name. Don't say just Narendra Modi. He's not your neighbor, he's not your classroom or a schoolmate. If you want to say and quote a personality like the Prime Minister, you say, the Honorable Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Damodar Das Modi. This carries a meaning. Otherwise, you create a negative impression. Any personality, you give your own opinion, that's the best. Agar kisi ka naam, kisi ka statement lena zaruri hai, to badi aadab se lena seekho. Speak with utmost honor and dignity. That is what will show your personality and project you well. Keep it simple. The answers should be very much focused and precise. Don't just speak about essays or volumes. Smile and make eye contact when you speak. That will keep your audience with you. Start strongly. That will show how committed are you? How determined are you when you give your own opinion? Justify it. Prove it when you speak something. Use your voice effectively. It should be clean and audible. Your accents are to be perfect. If you don't feel good about English or Hindi, you want to speak in Odia, ask the board, get the permission, and now you're through. Speaking Odia, using English in between, it is okay. But speaking in English and talking in Odia in between is not good. If you're not that good or that fluent in a particular language, doesn't matter. Language doesn't matter much. Your non-verbal communication skills matter more. So don't feel bad or low if you're not fluent in Odia, English, Hindi. Language doesn't matter much. Whatever language you are comfortable with and the board understands, and if that, get the permission from the board. Can I talk in Odia, sir? Mu Odia re kahi parivi ki? Given a nod, given the permission, you can go ahead. So don't feel bad about getting very fluent into English or Hindi, nothing like that. But your voice should be very much audible and clean. Use your body too. When you speak something in affirmation, your heads should be following it. Your body language should be very much aligned with your words. Relax, breathe, and enjoy. Wear a smile across. That is the beauty. Nothing to be getting nervous. Don't get panicked if you are not into answering one or two questions right, or if you fail to answer a couple of them. Doesn't matter. It is not your memory power to be tested in a board or interview. It is not your remembrance, but your understanding matters here. So don't worry if you forget something. If you are unable to remember, but use your common sense, use your presence of mind, use your determination, decisive skills, be confident, be proactive, be passionate, and be vibrant to answer. There is a thumb rule when you communicate. Feel it, show it, then say it. Feel, show, then say. If you feel it, your face will glow. Your face will be vibrant. Your looks will be something different. If you ask me to vibrate, if you ask me to comment on farmer suicide, if I'm not involved, if I'm not into that aspect, I am born, grown up, and brought up in a city. I have missed that rural life, farmer life. I cannot vibrate well. I may be coining words or thoughts inside, but if I truly belong to a rural area, I come from a village, I have seen, I have experienced farmers' lives. I know a person who had committed suicide in my village, in my panchayat, in my locality rather. So if you ask me such a question to vibrate on a topic like farmer suicide, you trigger it inside me. You trigger my emotions. You trigger my feelings. So once you get such a question, to be effective in your communication, that's what they say, feel it. A person who feels how it is to be farming, or being a farmer, and being into that critical tight corners, committing suicide, your face will radiate, your eyes will be wider, you will appear concerned, serious. It can be seen in your face. And then if you say it, you are through. So try to develop understanding upon certain aspects, certain themes, certain subjects. It is not to remember a lot. What matters in facing an interview or a board is to go there with a proper understanding of the things. Your understanding matters more than your remembering. That is what it says. How you estimate yourself as a professional? Because that is it, to show up as a professional. To have a professional approach when you meet a board, when you appear a board or interview. How you estimate yourself? How you measure yourself? So knowing yourself is very important. Start from your self-esteem. Start from your self-esteem. That is it. Start from your self-esteem. This is it. Know yourself. How you rate yourself. That is the beauty. If you can identify your weaknesses, if you can count on your strengths, then you can perform well and develop that professionalism. Be very much focused, appear concerned, appear very careful, appear decent and serious, specific. That is very important to be into something called professionalism, to be ready to take charge. If you communicate, that should carry a meaning. Look for persons you admire. If you quote someone, if you have some role models, if you have a person in your mind, if you admire anyone, so look into them, their personalities, their contributions. Update yourself regularly. If you are watchful, you can add to your credentials regular basis. Update yourself month after month, year after year. Add value to your credentials. That is very important. It is not to do away with your regular courses. To be a graduate or a postgraduate, there are several other skills as well. To be into computers, to be into leadership arena, to be into social work. So there are many other aspects where you can work upon and add value to your personality, update your credentials and increase and be aware of your talents and skills. Skills are those can be improved, acquired. It's not always a talent with everyone. But skills are open. There are certain skills that can be acquired. And if you have certain skills, that can be improved open. So work on that. Be aware of that, those skills. And relate it to the profession that you are for. The beauty here is, increase your likability factor. Why should people like you? Sell yourself well. Log aapko sunna pasand karenge. Log aapke saath rehna pasand karenge. People will love to be associated with you if they like you. So how to increase your likability factor? If you take others' opinions, if you ask for feedback, people feel good about. If you appreciate, if you judge them well, if you involve them, give them scope, honor their sharings, that is very important. And on the peak of that is to be trusted. To being a trusted partner is that what matters in the human being's life. It's not more important to be successful, to be great in this world. But it really carries a meaning when you are trustworthy. Kya aap pe bharosha kar sakte hain? Are you reliable? That is what matters. So always try to be a trusted partner. And when I say likability factor, each one of us in the world wants to be loved. Am I right? Main chahta hu ki har koi mujhse pyar kare. Everyone love me. How it is possible? You get lost. Agar aap wo karte ho jo sab karte hain, so then how unique are you? How you are different? And mind it, when you show up to be different, people will tolerate first. Never mind. But if you are justified, pursue it. शो योर यूनिकनेस, बी डिफरेंट, थोड़ा हटके बनो ना. यू हैव टू बी डिफरेंट बिकॉज यू आर डिफरेंट. गॉड हैज मेड यू डिफरेंट. नो इंडिविजुअल इन दिस यूनिवर्स आर आइडेंटिकल, इवन ट्विंस. जब सारे अनोखे हैं, यूनिक हैं, तो आप भी यूनिक हैं. सो शो इट. एंड व्हेन यू शो अप योर यूनिकनेस, पीपल विल टॉलरेट यू फास्ट. पीपल विल टॉलरेट यू फास्ट, दे विल नॉट टेक इट. एंड व्हेन दे सी दैट यू आर जेन्युइन, यू आर सपोर्टिंग, यू आर क्रिएटिव, you are adding value, your intentions are good, they will accept you. And when they get result, they get benefit, they will start respecting you. And then comes love. You will be loved. So tolerate comes first. People will tolerate you first. When you are unique, when you are different, you are tolerated. Never mind. Keep doing it. People will accept you. When they find results, when they gain, they will respect. And they are bound to love you when you are genuine. So increase your likability factor. Whosoever is loved is respected first. And respect is something that cannot be demanded. Respect is earned. Respect comes when people feel, people see the benefit, the gain, when the society is benefited by you. When you do, when you work, when you contribute for others, then you are respected. So respect precedes love. If you want to be loved, if you want to increase your likability factor, you need to earn respect. Before that, get ready that people need to accept you, and first of all, people will tolerate you because you are different, you are doing something apart. So be genuine, be yourself, and work on your likability factors. That is very important. That is very important. So take some guidelines, because there will be a question answer. There will be verbal communication. And you have prepared yourself with general knowledge, with communication skills, whatever experience you have. You have your career background into your credit. So they have the liberty to ask you any question. Very much something on current affairs. So get ready for that. Be prepared. Set the right tone. But mind it, being a professional is to be time bound. So you may or may not having much time to express or speak or communicate. So whatever you time you have, you get the time, sequence your points. What I mean is, you have many things to speak, but speak first what you must speak. If they keep listening to you, if they give you more time, then you speak what you should speak. If you are a wonderful speaker, if you mesmerize the panel, they give you more time to speak, you speak what you could speak. But never forget, getting a question from the panel, speak the salient points, speak what you must speak first. Then you speak what you should speak. And last comes whatever you could speak, given a liberty. So sequence your points, accent your presentation one after other, how well you present it, add right amount of polish. You need to fine tune. You need to customize your sayings. Check your technology. What do you use to speak? Whatever you have with you, permitted to carry with you. Don't bet on the internet. That's ever changing. Every moment it's different. You cannot bet on anything. If you get a counter, it's so kind, so beautiful to say, let me check it out myself. Let me learn this from you. I feel obliged. It's not to argue. It's to adapt. It's to make the board feel good about you. That is the point. Be very professional and recognize your non-verbal signals. You have to watch the panel members and very much be aware of non-verbal signals. If somebody yawns, that shows that your speech or whatever you say is boring. If somebody crosses his or her hands, means he's not interested. When you speak and they carry their body back on the chair, they say that you are not suiting to their expectations. So be very careful to watch. It's not only to show up your nonverbal signals or body language, it is also to be very careful watching the body language of the panel. So be interesting, be speaking on those points they will love to listen, and keep the board engaged. Look at each one of them and keep them engaged over your answer. That is the beauty. Then you can be impressive because your communication skills matter much. Your word power, your vocabulary, your positive mindset and thoughts. Because words, once they come out, cannot be taken back. Ek din Draupadi ne keh di thi, andhe ka beta andha, pura Kurukshetra ho gaya, pura ka pura Mahabharat ho gaya usi pe. So aisa nahi hai. Whatever you wish, you will speak. Speak well, speak that, what they will love to listen. Be very much polished and be very much professional in your speeches. That is very important. Posture. How you stand at the entry. How you request to get the seat. And when you wish, how is your body language? If you say namaskar with a smile, or if you say good morning, it is how you say that, along with your verbal communication, your body alignment should match. That is the beauty. So you have to take care of your posture. While sitting in the panel, in front of the panel on the chair, sit straight. Sit as if you are actively listening to them. Don't bend very much and don't be very much rigid, projecting your chest out. No. It's not to keep your hands or fingers crossed. It's not using your hands as if they will go above the table. So use your hand movements, use your leg movements, use your body movements very purposefully and very flexible manner so that it suits to the board their expectations. you do not appear to be unruly or wayward. So be careful about your posture. It's not leaning back. It's not head held up high. It's not bending your head. It's not head tilted to the side. A right body posture, looking anxious and upright, is very important. Hunched shoulders will speak about you lack interest. Crossed arms will show about your negative thoughts. So be very careful about many aspects of that. Overall, your gestures matter a lot. Even if you are not speaking, your very presence and your body language speaks a lot. So be very careful when you face the board and how you place yourself in front of them as far as body language is concerned or your postures and gestures are concerned. You can create a very, very good impression if you work well out on your postures. It's not important that you are not able to answer a single question or you answered it wrong. More than that, what matters is your posture, your gestures. Let us see. Your gestures. How you project at them, how you point at them, how submissive you appear, when you propose, when you place your thoughts, how you make your hand movements. That matters a lot. How you point at people, how you fiddle with your items. Don't drag your feet when you walk. It's not that. It appears sluggish, lazy. That is not. Don't sit your heads down. Don't shift your eyes like this. That shows you are not trusting. If I very often shift my eyelids, that shows I am not trusting you. So be very careful about it. That's what I said. Stay composed and stay stable. That is the beauty. Your body language should be very much into the acceptance mode. Don't put your hands in the pocket. Don't shake your legs often. It's not required, not advisable. So your gestures will make a great meaning when you are in front of the board. Very much it matters, your body language, your posture, your gesture. Sometimes you are asked to shake hands. You don't go right out asking for shaking the hands. And most precisely at this point of time, during this phase of this pandemic, people are very much scared about it. Don't ask anyone to shake hands with you. But you should know that a handshake carries a lot of meaning. If you shake hands with me, I'll scan your personality. Just by shaking hands with you, I can very well mark if you are interested or not. If you are a person to deal with or not. How good your personality or you are a bad character. Just by shaking hands with you, I can guess it. So a handshake, again, needs to be practiced. It has to be a business handshake or a proper handshake. Sometimes people just shake your hands on. That is not a proper thing to be with. So you should know what is a proper handshake. It has to be firm. It has to maximum last about 3 seconds. And it has to be making the person in front feel good. Have you marked the ex-president of America, Mr. Barack Obama, shaking hands? The man instantly takes his other hand and pats your back or shoulder, making you feel comfortable. So this is another good gesture to win over hearts, to create a warm setting. But for the time being, it's not good to shake hands. It is the best to adopt the Indian culture tradition of saying Namaskar. But for your reference, to know about this, then let us see what to bring or to carry when you enter a board or you go inside the room to be in front of the panel. What you need to carry? As I said, be prepared to prove what you are, because you are there to project your personality, to speak something unique than what you are, to speak something big about yourself, to speak something that is different from others. So often or obvious, people may doubt. People may put a question on your credibilities. So if possible, carry all those collaterals with you. If needed, you can show them to prove what you are saying is right. So when candidates ask me, "Sir, how to carry this? Should I keep it holding like this, or I need to keep it on my thighs, or I need to keep it somewhere and go? Should I carry all this or not?" If you ask me, I'll say, this is what you are. These are the few papers that prove what you are, that science to justify your sayings. Your career marks, your graduation papers, your extracurricular activities certificates, all your experience certificates, your recommendations, the references that you have got, the appreciation letters they have achieved. These are what matters for me in my life. This is what I am. So how can I part with that? I should be keeping or holding them tight with pride, because this is what it is. This is what I am. I cannot part with these papers lifelong. So these few papers are precious. So I am very careful about carrying it. Use a good folder to place all of that logically and sequentially. Hold it tight when you stand, and given a chair to sit, place yourself firmly on the chair and hold your papers very good, as if you feel proud about, and this is what as a lot matters for you in life. But be in readiness and keep it open, arranging them logically or sequentially, tagging them so that if it is required, you can instantly place it before the board, saying, "It's my privilege, my honor to prove yourself." So carry all those papers and references, whatever is possible, with you to the board, to the panel. No harm in that. Whatever you carry, carry with pride. That is what it is. Carry it with a good posture. Your body language should be proper and matching to it. It should not be very heavy, and it should not be very big in size. If you have certain credentials to your credibility, take pictures of that you can show it to your credit. If it is three-dimensional, a big objects that you want to show. But whatever you carry, carry with pride that is no harm to it. Your resume, portfolio, notebook, pen, leather folder, reference materials, address, phone number of references. These are a very few things that you need to carry along with you when you appear aboard. And at places when they say or ask you to leave it aside and go without anything in front of the members, okay. But if you are allowed to carry, these are a few things that you need to carry with you before the board. Next. Body language during the interview. Why I repeat this one again and again? Because I know a couple of candidates. Those are wonderful, wonderful, very genius guys. Once, twice, if I meet them for the third time, what happened here? Didn't you click last time? What went wrong? You know, this Viva voice facing these interview panels matters a lot. When they screen you out, you know, they screen you out only in these aspects. You may be a genius one as far as this power is concerned, but if nothing comes out proper from your mouth, or you are not exactly able to express yourself, project yourself, put forth yourself, convince the panel about your achievements, then it goes wrong. So be very careful about it. So your sitting posture, as I said, your handshake, eye contact, I'll underline or rather focus on this very point, eye contact. Nazare churana mat. Whatever you say, look in the eyes and speak. That is a sign of a beautiful and bold personality. Don't look at the skies or the roof. Don't look at other sides. Don't look below. Don't appear that you are just trying to remember. No. Whatever you need to speak, you speak straight looking at the eyes. That appears better. So always practice about maintaining a proper eye contact with the person. Your facial expressions again. How satisfied, how calm, how composed you appear, how you take the questions. Even if you are given a tight corner, a situation, leaving it to you to take a decision. When you think what to speak, or you simply do not dare to answer it, at all times, your facial expression should be neat and proper. You should not appear panicked, nervous. Many a times I have seen candidates sweating a lot. That shows your nervousness. Many of them just go on pressing their fingers. That is not wanted. That shows your nervousness. Be very stable. Be gentle, sober, submissive. Accept everything. Take time to answer. Don't be in a hurry. You're getting the question instantly, you answer, start answering. Even if you know the answer well, take pause, take time. Arrange them sequentially, logically, as I said, speak what you must speak first. That is the important point. So be very much composed when you go in front of them, and your hands in position when you are sitting in front of the panel. As I said, the table manners. Don't use the table. And if at all you have your credentials, copies of your mark sheets, you have your folder in place, portfolio, how you hold it, how you place it, how you carry it all along, how you sit down, and when you get up, when the board says Yes, you can go now. That's all of you. Please. So when you get yourself up from the chair, don't be in a hurry. Be slow and steady. Get up, place the chair properly where it was when you went inside. As it was, place it properly. And when you go back, come out of the board room, wish the panel, thank you, I'm grateful. It was a privilege talking to you. You can add to this. Wear a smile. You can do a namaskar again. That's a fine gesture. And it is not to go just backwards, no. Just the space from the door to the chair. You may take 1.5 step backwards, then gently turn around and go out. When you go out, be careful how you open and shut the door. That has to be very much noble and gentle. Don't bang. Don't be in a hurry. Don't get stressed. Or even don't get relaxed. It's all over now. No, it's not that. It's not over. You are watched. So be very much stable when you enter and when you leave the board. Your body language matters a lot. Self-talk is very important. What you talk to yourself, how you rate yourself, how you estimate your self-esteem, that is very important. Be realistic and truthful about yourself. Examine your pros and cons. Be kind to yourself. Face up the fears and be very specific. Check or clarify your perceptions, whether you are right or not. If you have a mentor, if you have a role model, if you have a person to interact with, you get a chance, check it out. Check the validity of your feelings and accept as it is. It's not always going to be very smooth. So practice, practice and practice a lot to improve upon your self-talk. That is very important. Practice a lot. That is what is going to make you perfect. So get ready for that. Are you? Yes. So practice will definitely make you better. Practice is what matters. And on the day, wish yourself good luck, all the best. And just take it. This is not the end of the universe here. This is just one event in your life. This very event, this very assignment or job is going to make your life. Who said that? This may be one turning point. Who knows the future? There can be a lot better than this for you. So if you and me, after everything optimistic, positive, giving the best out of yourself, somebody finds it not working, pat your back and say, you are still the best. And again, the best is awaiting you. Because this is not the end of the universe. This is not the end of life. Getting a job or getting this job very specifically, and this time, this year, this moment, is not going to decide your personality or your life. If you are committed, if you are determined, then you are a winner, no doubt. So your life is worth, because you are there. आपकी ये जंग, आपकी ये व्यक्तित्व सर्वोपरि है। ये ना मिला तो क्या, ये नहीं हुआ तो क्या, और ये मिल भी जाए तो क्या, दैट्स नॉट द एंड ऑफ द जर्नी। सो आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू अ वीडियो दैट विल अपलिफ्ट, दैट विल बूस्ट योर मोरल, बेगिंग परमिशन फ्रॉम ऑल दोज पीपल बिहाइंड दिस वंडरफुल वीडियोज, बट आई वुड लाइक टू शो यू दिस पीस बिकॉज दिस इज वॉट इज गोइंग टू वर्क फॉर यू। तो स्टे ट्यून्ड, स्टे हैप्पी, स्टे सेफ, स्टे ब्लेस्ड, बट स्टे प्रोडक्टिव एज वेल।